I wanted to be able to track how many punches that I was throwing. I decided to use the Circuit Playground Express board to do this. One, it has a 3-axis accelerometer on it, and it has neopixels that could light up to show me my progress, and when I was done, I could have a siren sound go off to signify that I had completed all my sets. And it also has easy make code that I can use, and it has event blocks, so every time the accelerometer threshold goes above 3G, 6G, or 8G, I can trigger a number of steps inside of that event block. So every time I threw a punch, I wanted a purple light to go off on the board saying, okay, we registered that you have thrown a punch. And I could set a threshold for the number of reps I wanted. So maybe every 5 punches that I threw were considered a set. So 5 reps, and that is a set. And then I could go up to 10 sets because that's how many neopixels there are. So every punch is a purple light, and we can go up to 5 purple lights. And then when I hit that, it starts at the bottom and says, oh, you've completed a set. We'll change to red. And then it will count those as it goes to the top. And when I've done 10 sets, then it's going to go off with a siren and be like, you've done it. You've completed the number of punches that you wanted to throw. Let's go over to MakeCode and figure out how we actually program that. To read the accelerometer, we could use an analog input or we could use an event. Events are easier because every time that goes above a threshold, either 3G, 6G, or 8G, it's going to allow us to do a bunch of steps. So that's the one that we probably want to use. And in the start of the program, we want to reset a couple of variables that we're going to track. We're going to track the number of punches, the number of sets, and we're going to specify the number of reps that we want to do inside of a set. So in the beginning, we want the punches to be 0, the sets to be 0, and we set the number of reps inside of a set to be 5. So every time we throw a punch and trigger the event, we're going to increase the number of neopixels that are purple by 1. And they stay whatever color we set them to until we turn them off. So we throw the first punch and we turn the first pixel to purple. We throw the second punch and the value for punch has increased by 1, so we're setting the next pixel to purple. And then when we've reached 5 punches, and that's the number of reps we said we wanted inside of a set, then we're gonna go inside the if statement and we're gonna turn one of the pixels red. And this is going to count how many sets we have. So we need to reset the neopixels so there's no lights lit because they were going to stay purple. And we're going to reset the punch count to 0 because we've gone through the number of reps we want in a set. And then we can't do the same thing we did above. We can't just go 1 pixel at a time because the set value is increasing and it would only change 1 pixel to red. And I wanted all the pixels to light up to show me the total number. So I created a for loop. So it's gonna start from 0 and then go up to the number of sets that we have. So for the first one, there's gonna be 1 red light, the second one, there will be 2, and so on. And after we turn on all the lights, we can increase the set number by 1. When we reach the maximum of 10 sets, I wanted a siren to go off, and then we reset the number for punches and sets because we've gone through everything, and we reset the lights. And if I wanted, I could start punching again and go back up to 10 sets. You can use this code in the Circuit Playground Express boards to track the movements of other things, like the lifting of weights. There's a link to the code in the description below if you want to use it. Let us know if you're working on any other projects. Thank you so much for learning and building with us today, and we will see you next time.